Go to like one.
Hey, what's up, everyone? Ace Speeds here with another Overwatch gameplay review. So today we'll be going over a Hammond game I had on Busan, just because Hammond is, you know, a lot more fun than Ursus if you find yourself, you know, wanting to play this hero, and it's pretty good on Busan as well. So might be pretty good to learning how to do the rollouts and where to take engage and stuff like that on this map. And with the meta changing, with the Rissa not being as strong kind of soon, you might see like him and dive and stuff like that on Busan, just because Koth maps are pretty good for dive. So we'll go ahead and get into here, and then
I'll go for you.
So I always like rolling out on this right side here, just because you can get the scout on their team as they're coming through.
Rig and Torb.
So we're kind of just letting our team know what they have.
I'm not getting past their shield. Oh, the Briggs won.
So we saw that they had the Rein there. So instead of going for like the slam, we went ahead and knocked them into our towards our team there.
Hey, nice ghost dash, man. Yeah, I saw it.
Just to get them past that Orisa shield, and then our team just followed up on the engage there.
They've got a widow.
You know, I just expect it from you, so I don't say nice job, because it's just, you know, I have high expectations.
So now we want to play this high ground. You always want to get the high ground after an engage, just so you can look for, like, a slam or scouting and stuff like that pretty easy.
Oh, they are? Okay, slamming.
So they're all pushing here, so then we go for, like, the slam. They got a purple, so now we're just going to roll through since we're waiting for cooldowns. And since they're playing on that edge, you can get the knockoffs like we did right there, which is pretty strong. So always want to try and take a fight at that corner if they're trying to go coast.
Easy, bro. Torb
can die. I'm out of ammo.
Okay, I'm on the hog. We kill Asana, we kill him. Me and you against the world. Wait, more no fade? Easy. Somebody clip, dude. Yeah, somebody clip it, dude.
So I thought it was pretty, you know, straightforward. And then, as you can see, now that we're done taking the fight, we want to try and start scouting where they're at. So, Kree's on the left side again. So we'll go look to see if we can knock him off. He doesn't get knocked as far.
I didn't knock him far enough.
But
you're the Hogs main. Hogs main.
Now we know that Kree's not there, so we can't take an engage from
Hogs main
if we want. So we got nanoed, so now we're just going to use mine to get a slam. We ended up missing it a little bit there, but so the reason why we put mines onto point like that was just because if they're going to take the fight onto point, there's a good chance that one of them is going to run into the mines and stuff like that, but they ended up having the Torbolt, so it killed off a lot of the mines there. So we could have maybe you waited a little bit longer, but overall, like, you don't really know he's going to use Torbolt and stuff. So before the fight starts, just throw mines on point, do the slam, and then try and get the picks. So I just wanted to get a little spam damage in. Going for the roll down there.
Q1.
Because since they do have the hog, if you're going to go and try and do a pile drive, you're just going to get hooked. So that's why we're starting to think he just off with the rolls through. Just because if he does, like, whatever hook you, it's, you know, a little bit harder than if you're just going to just go up in the air and then slam down. And then it can kind of displace them, so then your team has a better chance of following up on, you know, targets that are getting knocked around. So after you take those fights and stuff like that, just remember to always try and get like the high grounds either at top left, or you're going to be scouting the left side coast. And then, you know, by you like talking to your team and setting up the engage and stuff like that, it's pretty easy dives. Now on this map, you can either go left or right side. It's kind of up to you, whichever side you want to go from. I usually always try and go on
the right side
just because you can see
the scout where they're going
right here on this little corner. kind of same as like the last map where you can scout where they come through pretty safe.
Thank you.
And then you can set up a dive with your DPS if you want.
Simon Cree.
So there we go. We're, you know, letting our team know that we're going to try and like slam the Kree and whatnot. We're kind of low, so we're going to go out and get these health packs and then look for the re-engage again.
You got to juke mine a little bit. Wait, Kree, all right, Kree, first.
So we call for the, you know, killing the Kree just because he has like the flashbang and can kill your team in like, you know, one combo. So it's pretty easy if everybody's on him just to kill him. And he's the most immobile target. If you try and, you know, slam a Moira or, you know, one of those, like a Torb or something like that, a Torb can just E and survive it, and then Moira can just fade. So Kree's definitely the easiest target in this comp to kill every time. So if you want to try and look, see the easiest target, then go for that.
I'm slamming their tanks right now. Oh, just kidding. Yeah, they're slammed.
So we just call we're going to slam the tanks because, you know, they got anti, couldn't find anybody else.
Where's the one?
Yeah, I'm knocking past shield.
And now that we say like they put the shield down, so we just go for the roll to try and knock them out of their shield. Since we do have a Widow, we want to try and knock them away from the shield so our Widow can get value.
Every game you don't have a Derek on deeps.
Oh, because I can't be in all your games.
Him, come on. I'm gonna hit you with Nano this time, okay?
So here we're just waiting on like the left side just so we can see if we can scout them out anywhere.
Yeah, far right.
Yeah, they're far right.
So they didn't. We couldn't hear them on the close right.
You wanna put some
close side, so we know they're going over here.
Yeah.
So I'm just gonna use mines up in the air, since they wanna try and be on this side.
Get him, George. Bro, he just doesn't fucking die.
So our Genji wanted to do the Genji play there, so pretty much our job is kind of just to go in there. Hopefully make them use their cooldowns on us, and then our Genji is completely free there. So you put mines to try and displace them a little bit, so
they can't really go
everywhere. And then do the slam in just to see if you can take out like a break stun or any of the other rocks and stuff like that.
They have a Torb middle point one.
Yeah, you know.
There you go. A nice, easy Hammond game. Just to, you know, show that if you have set up the dives and stuff like that,
GGs.
You're actually just gonna, you know, own pretty hard. And if you use those scouting places, that you're gonna be safe before every engage. You don't really want to just be face checking, you know, hog hooks, maze, and break and stuff like that. So yeah, hope this helped for you guys. And until the next video, peace.